Hi there, everybody. I am back again with some more Endless Sky. But before I get too far into it, let me check my audio levels. I've changed the gains on my OBS. Oh well, you all can tell me if there's a thing. Alrighty. I'll check in a little bit. So, here we are. See, where are we? Let's look at our jobs. Okay, don't have any jobs and we don't have any cargo. Take a look at outfitter. No, the shipyard. There we go. Wow. 1.6 million. 40 cargo. Requires 3 crew. But has up to space for 17. Hauler. You know, the early days of the Republic, sudden increase in commerce and space travel led to high demand for cargo ships. Hauls were first created simply by bolting a cockpit engine block. Nothing's changed since then. Requires 5 crew, 130 cargo. Wow. Star barge. 50 cargo. Hey Colin, hang on a second. I didn't pull up my thingy. Give me a second. Pop out chat. There we go. I didn't set up my thing. Oh man, that sucks. Your Twitch has been screwy. That's messed up. I wonder if there's a problem with the app. We got an update or something. Can't see what else is in there. Actually, I know what it'll tell me. Jerome will tell me. How's my Twitch today? That's doing okay. It was okay this morning. Seems to be okay now. I don't seem to be any issues. Somebody made you an offer on your 360. You'd like to buy from you? A light warship. So keep safe distance from stars and move by the park horse until they're destroyed. Interesting. Kinda want that freighter, but don't know. So this is 20 with 6, this is 40 with 17, but crew costs money, so, alright, well, you have 2, 3, 6, therefore 100 bucks, 100 bucks on a 360, wow, you might have to take that. Hundred real bucks or 100 alternative bucks. All right, let's go to the job board. Right over here, in Switzerland. That's the other way. with games and a Wi-Fi adapter plus mod so it can play burnt disk. And it has a PC fan. Well, what modding do you have to do to make it play burned games? Two things I can do for New Switzerland. 10 tons, 4 tourists. I think we're gonna have to go do it. Alright, accept. Can I do 4 jumps? 1, 2, 3, 4. But I've never been there. Alright, so let's see. 76, 87 is the best. 128. 145 for heavy metals. Laser that reads this sensor and it to detect illegal copies games. So I paid my friend to install a PC reader for the disk tray. You can now play burnt games. Interesting. That's it's an interesting hack. Alright, so we'll go for heavy metals, I think. All 3 of them. Alright. Turns out that usually the more technical or the more rough the solution, the easier they're to defeat. Alright. Trading. Also found your first ever camera today. Interesting. What kind of camera is it? Oh, how's my audio today? Is it easier to understand me? Or is it actually harder to understand me? Oh, wow. That actually sounds pretty good. Sadly, the camera's broken, but the memory card's intact, and upon looking at it soon, audio's great. You see what 7-year-old you recorded. Hey, I found some audio recordings of me when I was, it's like 13 or 14, and with my little brother, who is 5 years younger than I am. That was pretty hilarious. I mean, that's 24 years ago, so before digital cameras even existed. All right. excuse me. Credits. Reactor-grade plutonium. That was a good delivery. Let's see where I am, map-wise. Interesting. Just remember, I was really happy when I got it because I bought it with my own money, and the first thing I did was go out in the woods and record myself climbing trees and crap. Fair enough. Da Vinci, New Iceland. Relic. Valhalla. Hayes. New Portland. Zug, New Greenland, Taluna, Vivitar DVR 508. Interesting. Was it like a 480p digital video recorder or something like that? Is it even 480p? Is that 240 or 360p? I do some exploration. Wow, that's awesome. There was a job to New Austria. Dang it. Oh well. New Austria is a rugged mountain world full of snow-capped peaks and valleys, so deep, so steep that they really rarely see sunlight. The few settlements that have been built here were developed for mining sapphires and rubies. Sapphires found in New Austria range from blue to yellow to black to clear in color. Are used for both industrial abrasives and for jewelry. For centuries, the locals have been trying to find a deposit of diamonds, which sell for a much higher price than with sapphires, and the local folklore revolves around the prosperity that would come to the world if diamonds were ever discovered. Let's see. Sell that. Watch the videos on the little one-inch screen it had, and we'll plug into your 360p. I think your regular TVs, like the old tube TVs, are 480p-ish. Actually, they're 480i. But, yeah. Alrighty. Okay, so there's our passageway through there. New Kansas, New Portland, Bluestone, that's a trip, Farseer, Hestia, Grandpa's old TV from the late 80s, wow. Those are some jobs. Let's go over here for our exploration, I guess. It's not in the right direction, is the problem. 1,750. Well, let's try it. Original Xbox on that thing. Had the CRT thing on it. What, the pronged one? It's called the Balloon. At least 100 hours on that camera. Wow. That's a heck of a lot of recording, dude. Lines would go across the screen. Yeah, that was definitely a thing. Let's go here. But I just love recording random crap out in the woods, and at night would rewatch it. Hey, you know, there's something very cool about it. Millions of years ago, this was a warm world, perhaps even tropical, but some cataclysmic event, perhaps a meteor shower, a massive volcanic eruption, altered the planet's atmosphere and has turned into a nearly lifeless frozen planet it is today. The first settlers came here to drill for the oil tap deep under the surface. A relic of tundra's former, more lively days. Instead of refining oil into plastic, which sells relatively cheap in this region, they have developed an industry in synthetic fabrics and clothing. Interesting. You have a couple of recordings of you and some of the neighbors having a stick fight. You getting smacked in the face and getting super bloody. Wow. Let's see. Yes, that's a profit. Check out. Job board. New China. Wrong way. Passengers to Clark. Sure, it'll be interesting, yeah. Twin Star. Shroud. Ada. Ada. Whatever it is. Rastaban. Alright. We can do that one. Let's see, what is low? These aren't really that low. Listen to the Vampires playing a benefit concert at Beetlejuice Stadium. New Iceland is perpetually hazy volcanic world with a slightly caustic atmosphere, but enough reserves of metal and petrochemicals to draw a large number of settlers. Some of those settlers also make a living as farmers, and a few will develop factory towns produce good for export to other worlds. Many of the inhabitants wear dust masks to avoid letting the particulate matter from the volcanoes accumulate in their lungs. Pretty sure it got water damage. If you think it's just water damage, what I would recommend is to take the screws off of it and just get some tap water, just regular tap water, and just let it soak for about 2-3 hours and wash it off really, really good. Then take it and put it in some distilled water for a day or so. And take it out, let it dry completely, and see if it works. I lived in a creek. I opened it up. Any metal on the side of it is very rusty. Okay, that'll do it, I guess. Let's see. Has to transport to Harmony. Geminis, New Kansas, New Wales, Skymoot, and Rand. Interesting. Yeah, why not? It's in the neighborhood, right? Be interesting. No inhabited plants that detected. Oh, awesome. Both of my destinations are reachable from here. Alright. Sweet. New Portland is a cloudy planet orbiting a dim star. The only reason it is not completely frozen is because of the heat trapped in by its upper atmosphere. There are only a handful of towns here, nothing big enough to warrant being called a city. Most of the settlers are subsistence farmers who can only dream about life on other worlds. Many houses here do not even have running water or personal computers. Some of the farms near the spaceport are planted with different crops, forming abstract patterns visible from the air. Such a whimsical extravagance seems particularly odd when you consider the owners will never be able to afford to see their fields from that angle. But perhaps that is precisely the point. This is the tongue-in-cheekiness of this game that I kind of like. Nice. Oh, you beat Bioshock? I was trying to catch one of those streams. I never managed to. Should I watch your... Did you upload any of those to YouTube? Alright, Cameron, Deep. Rush deliveries, I'm not gonna go with any of those. 19 tons of butter. Brother got you all three, so there's two more to beat. Nice. Let's see, trading. Let's see. Yeesh. Nothing too profitable there. Let's see. I guess the best thing right now is food, I guess. Even though that's still... Try to let you record the end. Twitch did not save the streams. That sucks. Did you turn that option on in your Twitch? To save the VODs? I guess you have to have if you've been uploading to YouTube from Twitch. There. Dancer. Dandruff, how goes it, man? Welcome to stream again. Pass the best of luck, Dancer. Collect my 82,000 credits. Okay. Dancer is a resource-rich world, but with unusually violent weather and strong atmospheric convection, which leads to lightning storms stronger than any other settled human world. Staying outside on foot is unthinkable, and it's not uncommon to find a small crater blasted out by a particularly energetic strike. Wow. A fair number of scientists have settled here to study plants' weather systems, as well as others who do not mind or who even enjoy the wild weather. It may be possible for terraforming to moderate Dancer's atmospheric activity enough to make it a less dangerous place to live, but the cost would be prohibitive. Let's see. Yay, they don't need food. Alright. Zug. China, the flood, there's Oblivion. Yeah, why not? Again, same neighborhood. Done. Alright. I'm gonna try going here. Just to explore. Cannot jump to the selected system. I got my ass kicked, is what happened. You have died. All right, well. All right. That was random. Today throughout human space is Remembrance Day, the anniversary of the beginning of the Alpha Wars more than 5 centuries ago. The Alphas were generic engineered soldiers with superhuman agility and intelligence, complete lack of compassion or empathy. At the height of the war, dozens of planets had been enslaved by the Alphas. Remembrance Day commemorates the beginning of the war rather than its end, as a perpetual reminder that the war is not over. Although the Alphas were defeated, some of them escaped and remained in hiding, and they and their offspring are presumed to still be present in the galaxy today. Since the Alpha War, genetic resequencing technology has been very tightly controlled because the Alphas were the product of experimental genetic manipulation rather than natural evolution. It is believed that their genes are less robust than human beings, and they are almost unable to have viable offspring without access to special technology. Therefore, most Alpha enclaves that have been discovered since the war have had very small populations, no more than a few dozen. In these days, when the Navy ensures peace throughout much of the galaxy, on worlds the Alphas are treated nothing more than a boogeyman story to frighten children, because the most striking physical feature of Alphas was their photosynthetic skin. On some worlds, kids even run around wearing green face paint on Remembrance Day, trying to frighten people. But on other worlds, especially on the fringes of space, where the Navy seldom patrols, the Alphas are still spoken of with fear. Your mom's old PC has a slot in you for the card. Cool, what kind of card is it? Oh, wow. That's a profit. Job board. Clark. Mirror. Oh, okay. So it's more than an 8 gig card. None of that. We'll buy that. And then we will go to there. It is a desert world too dry for much farming, and with gravity low enough to be uncomfortable for most human beings. It is, however, the best source of heavy metals in the galactic south. Aside from the managers of the mining companies, nearly all the people here are migrant workers from elsewhere in the dirt belt who have come to spend a season working for relatively high wages that uranium mining offers. Either send money off-world or save it up in order for a better life for themselves. Cool. Trinket. Where am I? It's pretty far. Camera, I used it. Oh man, that's not good. So if it has an SD card in it, that has to be a relatively recent computer. Do you know what's in it? Explore all in here anyway. It's a 2011 PC, but it's in rough shape. Yeah, but man, you could play all sorts of stuff with it. If nothing else, do some video editing with it. I mean, here's the point. I'm running a computer from 2008, and I'm streaming. Just to give you an idea. I mean, I'm not streaming like crazy games or anything, but still. Entire left side is leaking ink. Well, it's hard to argue with that, considering that computers aren't even supposed to have ink in them. That's magical. All right. What's cheap? flask is not that cheap. Heavy metals. It's a laptop. Computation powers to the roof these days. Streaming strength of the 9 CPU is fine. Q8400, man. Yeah, it's, yeah, man. It's... Hey, four processors is pretty sweet, no matter how you look at it. So, yeah, man. It's the second fastest Core 2 processor available. I think the fastest one was a Q9600. And it's only a little bit faster. Yeah, 2 gigs of RAM is pretty rough. Alright. But, you know, depending on the PC, I mean, you might be able to get like a 4 gig stick of RAM for it for just... you use for like $10. You'd be surprised what you can find at the Goodwill. Tell him, Dan. First desktop had 2 gigabytes of DDR1. I'm not going to tell you what my first desktop had. Your parents don't even let you use it. They aren't home right now, so I'm using it. It's weird that they don't let you use it. Why won't they let you use it? What, they store porn on it or something? Apple IIe, nice. Yeah, I gotta say, what was my first computer that I personally built? Ah! I even have the processor from it. Check this shit out. This is a Pentium Overdrive chip. This was the chip that was supposed to go into a 486 socket, but it had a Pentium core on it. 66 megahertz, but it ran like a bat out of hell in a 486 socket. It was the first processor that I ever had that had a fan on it. That one I keep around just because of the weirdness factor of it. All right, we're going here. Sweet. All right. All right, what's on the jobs? Well, actually, first of all, before I do that, go to trading. Ugh, negative 27. Yeesh. All right, well, let's see. New Austria. One passenger. I'm going here anyway. Don't think I'm going to take a rush delivery, though. move your old house. We'll go over here. There's a passage. They watched as a pine huddled close to a dim red sun and otherwise frozen system. Over so close to the sun that the two are locked together. One side of New Washington is facing the sun in another perpetual darkness. The only village in the twilight region between. Their settlers make a living by mining for metal for oil, a relic of warmer period when more life flourished here. Planets spun more quickly on its axis. It's not as tongue-in-cheek as I like it. offers a temperate world of oceans, mountains, and plains, both unfortunately high levels of sulfuric acid in its atmosphere. Metal and stone that are exposed to the atmosphere cool quickly, requiring frequent maintenance. As a result, hovers only a few small settlements, which the industry is focused on underground mining. The oceans are populated only by a few indigenous life forms who have adapted to their high acidity. Earth fish cannot be introduced successfully here. None of those. Oof. I think I'm going the wrong way. New Britain. New Britain is one of the few worlds in the durable region of the galaxy that is relatively prosperous and a large population. Although the gravity here is slightly low, it is otherwise nearly ideal Earth-like world rich enough in natural resources that all the raw materials for the local industry can come from on planet. Among the native life forms, the most striking are the many species of large and colorful birds, most of which have learned to give the cities and spaceport a wide berth. Fair enough. Sundrinker, New Sahara, the long jump. All right. Yep, that's not happening. Oh, welcome back on. Jeez. You uploaded it? Or uploaded a video? I have permission to watch on stream. I appreciate that. Alright. I guess that was really the audio that was the interesting part about that one. Nice. You should have put it on your face. Just so we could see the scream at the end. Yeah, I heard it. Yeah, if I was 9 and that happened to me, I probably would have had the same reaction. Oh, okay, he was hiding the camera. Gotcha. All right, done. Art. There we go. Terra Z. Quarg. You had seen pictures and videos of the Quarg before, but this is your first time in a spaceport that is owned by them. The architecture is truly alien, uncomfortably tall ceilings, strange colors, and walls that never quite seem to meet at right angles. The Quarg themselves are equally strange, towering above you some nearly 3 meters tall. Their legs bend backwards at the bottom like a dog walking on its hind feet, and they move gracefully and almost silently. Most of the Quarg you see are dressed entirely in shades of gray or only slight hints of color. Quarg fashion seems to revolve not around color, but texture. Coarse and fine woven fabrics, patterns like lizard scales or cobblestones, and occasional decorative fringes of sponge-like material. The skin is a deep gray, sometimes with a hint of green or blue or brown beneath it, with a fine scale pattern like reptile. But what makes their eyes startling is that they look very human, except that some of them have gold or violet irises instead of green or blue or brown. They have no hair, but many are wearing small cloth caps or hoods. One of the Quarks notices you gawking at them and walks over. It squats down on its haunches so that its eyes are level with your own and says hello. Its voice is deep, sounding like an accordion or buzz of a beehive blended with the hum of a starship engine. Speaking slowly and deliberately, it says, I think you are new here. Are you what is called a tourist? No, I'm a merchant captain. I'm here to buy and sell cargo. I see. The cork blinks slowly. Its eyes come from the sides of its eyes, so up and down. It's an otherwise so human eye. The effect is disconcerting. Many humans have many questions when they see us. Someone the cork lived for many lifetimes of humans. It is not burdensome for this one to speak with you. Can you tell me about the Korg? Are there other alien species in the galaxies in order to speak with you, but I do not have any questions. Can you tell me about the Korg? We, the Korg, are unique of all the species in the galaxy. Our species began at the moon of a great gas giant on a planet most small that gathered about itself very little air. We cannot step many steps on the worlds that the Korath, the other species, desire. And the worlds like our home, you could not breathe their so thin air, for our lungs are very subtle. And we are an old race and do not kill for sport or whimsy. So the Drak gave us the gift that we may go amongst the other races and settle where we please and make friends of all, because none dare be our enemy. What is the Drak? The Drak are the eldest living, not the firstborn, for they are long gone, but the eldest living, and they are yet far younger than the stars. They tend and cultivate the pathways between the stars and prune away the paths the species could travel and make war against each another. They hold the secret of the travel beyond those pathways and give the secret only to a worthy few so that peace may prevail. It taps its chest with one hand, signaling that the Korg are among those few. Not that the Drak are strangers to war. Planets and moons and even stars were consumed in the wars and are no more. But then they learned wisdom and have fought no more wars many millions of human years. They live nearby, but they keep to themselves and intervene in the affairs of other races only to prevent their destruction or to use or the use of obscene technologies of war. We humans have used some destructive weapons against each other, and no alien species have ever stepped in to put a stop to it. I hope we never do anything bad enough to force them to intervene. Hope so too, human. The Korg stands up, towering over you once again. As long as you are a seeker of peace, you are most welcome in our worlds at any time. It bows to you. You're not sure if it's a Korg gesture too, or if it's simply imitating a human custom, but you bow in return, and the Korg walks away quietly. Interesting. Small Korg outpost, which you suspect was built mostly to keep an eye on Terra Z Corporation and their alien influence research on the planet below. Like most Korg worlds, gravity is much too low here for it to be feasible human colony. Although there's an atmosphere, it's too thin for a human being to breathe. Supposedly, Korg lungs are designed for continuous one-way airflow like a bird's lungs, rather than the ordinary in-and-out flow of human lungs. It is what enables them to survive in low-gravity, low-atmosphere worlds. Alright. Greenland. Arabia. Might have to go there. Flood. Reunion. Okay. Let's see. It was very low. Mile. I screamed, now I can't play video. Yeah. I did hear that. I wonder if my dad broke the camera because that was the last thing that was recorded. Interesting. All right. Presidency settled by team science, diplomats seek to build a relationship with Korg worlds, galactic southeast of here, partly through the aid of Korg and partly through a desire to emulate them as growing to a very technologically advanced world. Tires of a corporation make up alien inspired ships and outfits, one of the largest industries on Wayfarer, and they draw raw materials from this throughout the region of space. Blackbird, huh? 5 crew required, 60 cargo. 50 cargo, 3 bunks. You know, I can't tell. Like, some of it is very intricate. You know, like that part right there where it's just storytelling, and other parts are just kind of like matter-of-factly written and completely uninteresting. So, I don't know. I can't tell what it's supposed to be. I think it has a little bit of an identity crisis, honestly. 15. Interceptor Sparrow. Heavy warship. 90. Wow, 56 crew. Wowza. That's going to be interesting. Did I look? Yes, I did think I did. Alright. Quark built the station centuries ago before they began construction on the ring world. From the dark side of the station, the ring is visible as a thin, bright filament stretching out to either side of the system's sun. The ring itself is close to human visitors, but tour shells depart from here on a regular basis, giving human tourists a closer view of this engineering feat that's so beyond anything human beings have ever attempted to build. Interesting. That. Alright. Cycle garbage. Okay. That's a good payment right there. Too bad I don't have any space. So this is the Quark quadrant, I guess. The gravity is too strong as a problem for the Quark to have, so they've welcomed human settlers instead. Many people who want freedom from the dangers of human space and less instability of human government have settled here. The regions near the equator are far too warm to be comfortable. The climate closer to the poles is almost ideal. The only reason Humanica is not as densely populated as some of the worlds farther to the galactic north is the distrust with which most humans view the Quark. No jobs. Quark log is a Quark mining world barely habitable by their standards because of because it was low gravity, unsuitable for long-term human habitation. Quark City is a marvel of advanced technology, entirely enclosed with glass and steel, with gardens and terraces where alien trees and plants grow. Outside the city, the landscape is rugged and beautiful, but the atmosphere is too thin to breathe and contains almost no oxygen. Okay. Alrighty. Any jobs? No. I did go there, didn't I? Yeah, I did. It looks like I have to go the hard way. Alright. Done trading. Let's see where we can go. 1, 2, 3, 4. We'll go there. Heavy metals will fetch 142. Okay, we'll take some heavy metals with us. Because we'll just go ahead and explore while we're at it. So 142. A low. Oh. Ha. Hello, Vasily. How's it going, man? Oh, thank you for the host. Let's see. So I want heavy metals. Alrighty. Supposed to do here. All right, let's see. Weapons targeting. Talk to selected ship. Scan. Shift key, talk to the planet. Next ship. Okay. This is my ship right here. Up, yes. I'll be there in a minute. Interesting. You gonna dual stream? Let's see. Yeah, I'm actually going to sign off here in just a few minutes. Let's see. South on a galaxy map. Yeah. They, it's interesting, right? Oh, awesome, man. New news: first settled less than a century ago, and the settlers are still struggling to establish themselves. The hospitable climate, but the amount of labor needed to clear forests and plow rocky fields has meant that the towns here can only grow very slowly. Farmers grow both food crops and cotton, and very recently they've become manufacturing their own textiles and are just shipping the raw cotton off world for processing. See, that's like matter of fact. You know, that's not an interesting thing. Wow. Okie dokie. Elf. I'm going over there. No. Alright, I'm gonna have to take care of some of this stuff, so. Yep, they're the same guy. First, I looked into how many were an Amish community, seeking a place where they could live a quiet life and do work with their own hands, they were relying on machines and computers. Their community grew to millions of people, and now they're side by side with other more modern settlers. There's still regions of the planet where motorized vehicles are prohibited, but in other places, trucks and horse-drawn buggies share the same roads. I'm going to sell that. Jobs, Twin Star. To be metal, which I have plenty, I had plenty of. All right. Dang, I got my ass kicked. Alright. Well, you know what that means. It is time to call it quits. I have died. Hard for me to argue with that. So thank you guys for joining my stream. Let me see if anybody is on that I can throw to. EJ Rocket PC. I'll throw it over to Colin. Yeah, thanks for joining, Dan. Sorry, trying to do two things at once. And, thanks, Vasily. Same to you. Alright, there we go. Alright. And again, thank you for joining me. I'll see you guys next time.